I am not an artist, nor am I a filmmaker. I am an artigiano, which describes my work, my art, my craft in Italian. In my work, I make allusions to books that nobody else has read, music that nobody else has heard, and art that nobody else has seen. And I only use the Italian language in my work because I feel that the English language is too limited. I found out about my talent at the early age of 6 months, when I stopped watching television because it was so boring and stupid. I started reading books and going to recitals and art galleries. I don't go to recitals anymore because my hearing is too sensitive. And I don't go to art galleries anymore because there are people there and I can't deal with people because they don't understand me. I stay home reading books and working on my work, which no one understands. I watch films by directors such as Fellini, Lang, Pasolini, and Truffaut. But that's only when I'm not working on my work, or when I'm extremely bored. Whenever I need to leave my house and face other people, I wear the darkest pair of sunglasses I own. Not only because it is bright outside, but because I don't want people to look me straight in the eye. It makes them want to smile at me, and I can't stand smiling because it makes my face ache. But most of all, because people wear such loud colors these days, and my eyes are too sensitive to color. I wish the world were in black and white. I start every day off with a double vanilla latte with soy and whipped cream. I can only drink soy, not milk, because my stomach is too sensitive. And I only drink through a straw because the brims of most cups are filthy. I hate having to come to the coffee shop because there are people there and they don't understand me. I am saving money to purchase my own espresso machine so I don't have to deal with people anymore. When I go to the coffee shops, I feel like the people there are trying to read my secret thoughts or steal my ideas as I study my work. I don't understand why they try to read my writing. They wouldn't understand them because I'm so deep. I spend a lot of time reading books and working on my work at cemeteries because all of the people there are dead. They don't bother me. Everything is gray, clean, and quiet. Another one of my safe havens is my rooftop. The sound of the wind and the warmth of the sun calms my nerves, allowing me to work on my work more fluidly. Sometimes I can't go to my roof, though, because my skin is too sensitive. If I stay out in the sun too long, I begin to blister. I like to film most of my work at cemeteries because a lot of symbols are present. In fact, the film I have just locked is a myriad of symbols conveyed through images I have collected from a few of my secret spots. I shot the film in black and white using a Super 8 camera. The score I chose was a piece that I have been composing for almost a year. I composed it. I performed it. This way I was in control of the messages I was trying to convey to my viewers. I will not allow anyone else to compose music for my films. When someone else's music is used in my work, it tends to distract my viewers. I want them to be focused only on my work. I always structure my films in such a way that people have to view them twice, because they would not understand in one viewing.
Back in it.